another rust lesson on this mini boot lid. Short story, I've replaced half the skin here, the other half I thought I'd have a go at brazing up, which seems to have gone very well with silicon bronze here. The rest of this doesn't seem too rusty, but the frame, inside frame, was a problem. Here it was here, tucked under the skin, or the edge of that skin, and I went to braze it and it just all blew out at me. I couldn't really fill those rust holes with silicon bronze. It's just got a whole lot of really bad rust and some kind of thick, gooey rust kill or rust sealer, so that's no good to me. I had to cut it out. Use these edge lifters. I don't want to give too much away, but I actually made these out of a pair of nail pincers. If you come and have a look, welded this piece of flat bar across here and just reprofiled this edge out of a pair of pincers and took the leading edges off there. Could be a lesson. The best tools ever are the ones you make. So all you do is sit that up against that edge and you squeeze it in, and it just quietly and gently lifts that edge up, as you can see it's doing right now. And then you just keep going a little bit further and further with each bite. So you squeeze it in further and further and further to the point where you can just squeeze it right up and quietly roll it back all the way along. That way you can unpick an edge and get to it to repair the frame or take the skin off if you need to put the skin back on, which is a really big job. You don't really want to go there. Here's my patch. Cut this to length. Here's the trick I want to show you guys today. What I want to do, this one here, when I replace this inside edge, you can see the weld. I have just welded it flat right through there, right under there. This time I'm going to fold it up, put a small fold on it, and then fuse that on just under those holes with my TIG welder, and then you, when the rubber goes back on the boot lid, you won't actually see the joint. But here's the problem. It's got a slight curve in it, and you can't fold 3 mil. All I'm looking for is around 3 to 5 millimeters upfold. So what you've got to do to get around that is fold a bigger edge. I'm now going to fold a 10 mil, which will allow it to fold in my folders, and then in my shrinker, my stretcher shrinker, I'm able to pull a slight curve in it to match that. You're sick of me talking, let's just do it, eh? In we go. I'm going to fold this on the 10mm mark. This is boring, you're not going to learn much here. But like Jamie Oliver, he still has to cut the carrots before he can make the main meal. So we'll squeeze that puppy up. Fold that right angle, 10mm, but I have all intentions of cutting that down to 5mm. There's no way this will fold 5mm. You can also do this at home. I've shown you in the previous lesson that you can use your, where's my bin? Oh, here's my bin. You can use your homemade folders and just hammer that over like that with your angle iron. Don't have to have a set of folders like me. It just makes life faster and easier. Now you see, that's going to sit in there, butt up in there, but I don't want that much material on there, but I need it to fold it. I need it to put a curve in it, which I'm going to do right now. My shrinker. Again, just going to pull it around real quietly, because it's such a gradual curve. You don't have to buy one of these machines either. You could actually pucker and hot shrink, but that takes... That's another lesson for another day, which is how we used to do it in the old days before people invented these. Or your boss wasn't so tight that he went and brought the panel shop one for everybody to use. That'll now sit in there. See, it's got a little bit too much curve in it now. But that's great. That's a good thing. Slightly pull that back. Or just change the jaws, and I'll use the stretcher to push it up. So now that goes in there. Oh, look, that's close. That follows that curve. So now I don't need the 10mm, because I only want to weld it on here on the 3mm or the 5mm mark to sit just under those holes, so it's all nice and tight, nice and snug. Just the way I want to work. You could weld it on there and then redraw those holes and use the boot rubber to hide it, but that's not how I operate. So now I'm going to grab that, grab my tin snips, you'll get bored watching me, and I'm going to cut that off at the 5mm mark and just throw that piece of steel away. It'll loofen out. I'll show you how to weld it, fit it in a minute. Tape.